I'm using the head of a 850-014 burr to create 3 depth cuts along the incisal edges of each tooth. Once the depth cuts have been marked, I switch to a larger 850-018 burr to expedite the finishing of the preparations. The plan is to enhance your smile with veneers, to increase the size, close the spaces, and also to go much lighter. She wants to aim for a Hollywood BL1 shade. Using the next evolution in our zirconia restorations, BruxZir Esthetic. I begin the preparation directly through the mock-up. By preparing through the mock-up, I'm able to ensure the final restorations have the appropriate material thickness while reducing tooth structure only in the areas that require it. I'm using the head of a 850-014 burr to create 3 depth cuts along the incisal edges of each tooth. For the facial depth cuts, I first ensure that the tip, which is 0.8mm in diameter, begins the depth cuts at the margins and then gradually connects to the incisal. I place 5 depth cuts on the facial, 3 near the center and 1 along each line angle. The depth cuts are then marked with a lead pencil so I have an easier time identifying when I've blended the unprepped areas down to the ideal depth. Once the depth cuts have been marked, I switch to a larger 850-018 burr to expedite the finishing of the preparations. Now it's just a matter of ensuring the finger projections at the incisal edges and the facial surfaces have blended together through the depth cuts, resulting in a smooth and continuous surface throughout the preparation. Anytime we lengthen teeth with veneers, a flat incisal edge preparation is preferred for ease of fabrication, smooth path of insertion, and a great adaptability of the restorations to the preparations. The incisal edges have a slight angulation from lingual to facial. For the teeth adjacent to the diastemata, the preps must be extended farther interproximally to allow room for the final restorations to create the desired emergence profiles and contacts. When we prepare teeth, the axio-occlusal or axio-facial line angles typically result in a sharp angle since the burrs we use create flat planes. It's good practice to round these over to minimize the amount of internal stress placed on the final restorations. To ensure the labial incisal transitional line angle is smooth and rounded, I use a coarse Venus Super polisher along these aspects at 5000 RPM. All of the finished margins terminate at the free gingival margins of each tooth. I typically use a dual core technique, but wanted to try something a little bit different. Since all the prep margins are at the free gingival margin, right equigingival, I'm going to place only a size 1 retraction cord along all of the teeth to help displace the gingiva slightly for our final impression. Once the retraction cord has been allowed to sit for 5 minutes, we'll remove the cord and then begin flowing capture light body PVS material along the margins and into the sulcus. You can see with just one cord how the tissue has been displaced enough to visualize the margins. Once the light body has been applied, I'll now slowly adapt the anterior triple tray filled with heavy body material to the preps. Once the impression has been taken, we'll then get the patient ready for their provisional restorations. For the provisionals, I'll use a shrink wrap technique using the same putty matrix that we use for the initial mock-up. I first spot etch each tooth with Kerr's 37% phosphoric acid, followed by a thin coat of 3M Scotchbond Universal, which will light cure for 10 seconds. Now I'll fill the putty matrix with tough temp Bisacryl material and then slowly seat that over the teeth to minimize the inclusion of any air bubbles. With the scalloping created on the putty matrix, it's quite easy to remove the excess from the facial with an explorer or scaler.